in general, security intelligence is at a premium these days. It seems like almost every corporation and most governments are looking to find out about attacks and malicious activity as they're happening. Typically, organizations have a pretty good feel of things that are going on within their network, but they have difficulty getting visibility into organizations or actors who are attacking them. We can tune and customize work that we do with our security intelligence services team to give specific information on individual industries or on individual companies and governments about attack activity that's occurring for them. Another in the financial sector has to do with banking fraud and, in general, phishing attacks that are designed to steal credentials to get money from individuals and from companies. So a few other things that we hear about a lot these days are industrial control systems and critical infrastructure. That's one. Security in the cloud and in virtualized environments. That's two. And number three, mobile. So with regard to industrial control systems, a lot of the systems that we see in a variety of environments, whether they're manufacturing environments or they're critical infrastructure environments, rely on SCADA technology. And back when that was designed, it really wasn't designed with much or any security in mind. Many of these systems are highly customized systems, and it's difficult to introduce security after the fact. So this is a very important area from a national critical infrastructure perspective and from an ongoing business perspective for manufacturers and other organizations that rely on these systems. So this is an area where there's a lot of research being done and some really interesting new technology being developed. The second area in terms of security in the cloud and security in virtual environments is another area where there's a lot of innovation going on. We've recently introduced some new technology to the marketplace in the virtualization space that allows you to maximize on the goals of the virtual environment in terms of high density of virtual hosts while also achieving security. A third area that we hear about a lot is mobile security. We've been talking about it for quite some time, but there's still plenty of holes in terms of what organizations have in place for security on mobile devices. And with the proliferation of tablets and smartphones and people using laptops and all of these different devices that are being brought into the networks, security has become an increasingly complex task for IT administrators and security administrators. And so it's really important to bring powerful tools to help them manage that environment and to control those devices appropriately. Kaspersky is offering a number of new solutions and technologies that we've developed over the years to address some of these problems. One of the new services we're offering is our security intelligence services, which harvests the real-time threat and attack information that we have and we're developing and gathering on a minute-by-minute basis through the Kaspersky security network. And it combines it with real-time expert analysis that our team does on threats and malicious code to provide really insightful information about external attacks that are occurring to organizations from threat actors out there in the world. We also have technologies around fraud prevention that are custom built to work in the banking and financial services environments to prevent attacks and the theft of credentials and information. In addition, we also have virtual security technologies, which can be used in either agentless or light agent based solutions to accomplish a variety of different needs and objectives for organizations in the cloud and in the data center to help them solve those issues. On the mobile security front, we've had a number of different solutions and components that we can bring to bear depending on what the objectives, again, of the organization are. And we've continued to expand and deepen that portfolio in terms of the technologies as well.